We're gonna get lots and lots of steel. Just check this out. This is seriously one of the best bases I've raided, like top 20 bases. Look at this, bunch of steel. Maybe even like top one base with the amount of steel I've gotten here. Hey yo guys, it is me, Happy Saiyan. Welcome back to Last on Earth Survival. So we're gonna start off this video by doing a junkyard event because last time I failed it. So hopefully this time it's gonna go a bit better, and I can already say that this is a different junkyard event because there is no guy here. Usually he was supposed to stay here. And it looks like this is gonna be event with raiders, isn't it? Okay, so I'm gonna take this AK just so that it's a bit faster to deal with them. Even though, again, Glock is alright. You could probably even do it with melee weapons, but the more AKs, the better. Okay, so these raiders are gonna drop broken armors. We don't really care about that. Spit on that broken armor. I remember back in the good old days when AI would drop you like full durability weapons. They weren't really full durability weapons, but at least they were like 20-30% durability. And after each update, they kept giving less and less stuff. Okay, stupid raider. Sayonara, let's heal up a little bit. Kind of like activate this scar alarm. And I'm gonna take care of the spreadsheet because I assume lots of zamzams are gonna come here. What's interesting is that raiders don't hear that, but only zombies hear that. Wait, so what's up with that? Zombies didn't come after me, that's weird. Maybe in this event they don't come, or maybe they do come, whatever, let's deal with this raider. Another raider, quick healing up. Oh wow, that's a lot of raiders! I had 20 health, I thought I'll die. I thought I'll die because there's usually like half a second or maybe even less. Like maybe 0.1 second delay before I can heal. And I thought that's it, I'm gonna die. But hey, this chopper is gonna have a little bit of gasoline, and probably every chopper here is gonna have a little bit of gasoline. So if you're smart enough, you can bring here empty bottles. But hey, I didn't bring anything, so I'm gonna try to get this engine. If you need to probably give engines for raiders, maybe you can get them from here. Once again, I don't remember if that stuff works or not. Whatever, let's loot this car. And here we'll get... let's get a little bit of duct tape, better than nothing. So over here on that side, there's gonna be another guy that we have to save. He'll let us open up the chest. Like, is he gonna give us the key? What does he say? Okay, so I think it hit me. Okay, you're not one of them. Thanks for the help, your reward's in the chest. But like, why can't I open up the chest right now? Did he give me the key or something? Would be awesome if he like, oh, take the key, open up this chest. But yeah, that's kind of weird, you know? He's on the verge of death and he's like, oh yeah, you helped me. Go open up my chest. It's kind of weird. Whatever, let's loot this convoy thingy. And over here we'll get one bandage. Okay, okay, okay. But again, the main loot is going to be in that chest, not inside of these cars. And here I'll get a little bit of gasoline. I mean, three canisters of gasoline is actually really, really nice. Plus, if we're gonna combine all the other gasoline that we can get from the choppers, this is pretty good. It's not actually that bad. Okay, let's get more duct tape. Maybe I've missed some cars. Maybe I've opened all of them, but let's open up this chest. Oh, we didn't even have to load it. Okay, so here we're gonna get this biker magazine, which I'm gonna take. I'll give it to Jennifer at the gas station. I'm gonna take dry food. I'll take more gasoline and some other garbage. So you know what? Just from this junkyard event, we've gotten 6 gasoline and plus more gasoline that we would have gotten from those empty bottles. So this event gets IX approval, a really nice event for more gasoline. So now guys, let's do a blind raid. It's been quite a bit of time since I've done completely blind raid. So I've done zero research on this base. And again, if this base is gonna be like something huge or whatever, I'll obviously do more research on it. But doesn't really look like I'll have to do research on this base. Doesn't really look like it. It's like literally, it's not even 3x3 base. It's even smaller than this. I'm super disappointed. Wait, I just checked if he has anything else on the other side of the map and it looks like he has not. Thing. Like, this is probably gonna be one of the worst bases ever, but again, Sayek, don't judge the book by its cover! Yeah, whatever, I don't know. I'm gonna try to place a C4 over here on the door. At least this is a unique looking base, alright? I'm trying to stay positive here, and this base is gonna have 4 chests. That is so awesome! Okay, so I dropped the C4 back in my chest, and let's open up these 4 chests, and let's see. What are we gonna get inside? Whatever, baby. I'm not even excited for those 4 chests, but we might get something good. I mean, I'll get a little bit of stones. Gonna drop them in the chest to craft more level 1 hatchets. That's always better than nothing. And just because this base was so trash, probably I'll do one more raid. So smash that like button on the video if you're excited about raids. And today we're also gonna talk about some future stuff that is coming to Last on Earth. We've gotten some more sneak peeks, so we're gonna talk about that a little bit later on. But now let's continue with the raid. And we've gotten 2 Glocks. You know what? Just this raid, like from complete trash, it just became all right. It just became all right. I'm gonna eat some berries because why not? And let's open up. Okay, so we still have 2 extra chests. I thought this is the last chest. Here we go. Let's open up the last chest. And here we are gonna get nothing. Again, probably planks are worth it if you don't have them, but we have lots of and lots of planks, so I'm not really taking any more. Here we're gonna get 1 red ticket and 8 duct tape. Okay, so I'll try to exit. No, can't exit. Can I exit right now? No, they're gonna corner me, these stupid schmucks. Let me out! Don't tell me that I'll have to fight them. Don't tell me that I'll have to fight them. No! I just got him. I got him. Okay, so this base does not get Sykes' approval. I spit on that base. So now let's do 20 waves, and after that we're gonna go for one more raid, but those are not gonna be just simple 20 waves. I brought with me an MGL and a little bit of grenades. So we should be able to do those 20 waves just like this with a snap of a finger. And it should be more fun. I always love using those grenades. And at the same time, you might have seen the recent video that we've done on doing those 99 waves. I think I'll do those 99 waves more frequently because they seem really fun to do them on the live stream, as a lot of people are hyped for them. I am hyped for those 99 waves myself. Spreadshot. Yes, at least I got them. And I want to maybe open up more purple crates. Maybe I'd love to do another like purple crate opening video where we open up like 5 purple crates. But hey, that's just all for the future. We will see how it's gonna go. All I know is that on the wave like 7 or 8, I'll start using my grenades. Wait, where can I start using it? Here goes Spreadshot and Zombie Officer Sayonara. So that's wave 2. Let's go for the wave number 3. And yeah, probably on wave 7, 8, yeah, I'll start using those grenades. There's no need to save them. Here go, this dude is dead. Let's take another Glock. Let's activate wave number 4. I'm gonna take the Spreadshot, I think. Okay, so 4 of those guys already. Spreadshot just in the face. So I think I'll already start picking up cards, because the more cards will be lying on the floor, the more the game starts lagging. At least that's what happens for me, so I'm not just gonna leave any cards here on the floor. I'll pick them up. The less lag, the better. Here got the 5th wave. And there's already lots of zombies. Yeah, on 6th wave, maybe we'll already start using nades. Yeah, why not? Let's do it. Let's do it. Just for the memes. Just for the fun. Let's deal with the brawler. Explosive Zamzam is going to explode into smithereens. And now my riot zombies, say your last words. Here go, riot zombies done. So I'm gonna use, you know what, let's use my, nah, we're gonna use grenade launcher a bit further on. Now, you know what, I wanna use it right now while I still have some armor, because I don't like using grenade launchers, to be honest with you. I prefer using grenades, as grenades are a bit more safe than grenade launchers. So what I'll do here is do a little bit of the circle, just like this, healed up and beautiful, and Spreadshot on top of them, and zombie officer Sayonara. Oh, also, we have some mines. Can I use some mines? Oh, maybe I used all of the mines already. No, I definitely didn't use all the mines. Wait, on wave, whatever, on wave 15, I'll use the mines, because I do have a couple of them in my inbox. Wait, let's take at least one, and I'll use one mine. I want to save more mines on further waves, like on wave 99 or something, when we'll be doing more waves once again. Okay, so I have some grenades there, and we have 4 landmines. Okay, so let's take one more landmine, and I'll show you how you have to place them, if you haven't seen that live stream yet. So let's bring, no, not the mines. Let's take the nades. Let's start another wave. I'm gonna go to the top. I'm gonna throw that nade. I'm gonna stay on top of it. I'm gonna exit it. Boom. Oh no, I missed it. I missed it. How could that happen? Stupid head, stupid Cyric. You did not see that. You totally did not see that. How did I fail? Whatever, let's take 2 bandages. Let's deal with this riot shielded zombie. Here we go, Glock did the work. And maybe I'll be even able to get one blue card. I'd really love it. The more blue crates, the faster I'll be able to exchange them for purple crates. Yeah, I think that's what we'll do. That's what we will do. Let's go to the top. Let's throw the nade. I'm gonna stay on top of the nade. I'm gonna start exiting it. Beautiful. That was kind of perfect. Kind of failed throwing that nade. It went to the side. But hey, at least I was able to damage all of them. Let's go over here. Wave 9. Throwing another nade. Staying on top of it. And now exiting. Beautiful. Another awesome shot. Another perfect shot. And as I already said a couple of months ago, probably maybe even a year ago, if when you go on dictionary and you type perfection, you will literally see like this gif of Cyric throwing the nade and them exploding, because it's cool. It's seriously perfection. It is perfection. Here we go, let's drop the nade. And it's also really satisfying to see that. Look at this. Boom, all of them just exploded. Like, it's super satisfying. Like, I don't know what's more satisfying in this game than throwing a perfect grenade. Maybe also using a Spreadshot when you have to fight the witch and a bunch of those, like, crawlers. Yeah, when there's, like, 50 crawlers and you Spreadshot them with one shot. That's kind of satisfying as well. But using the grenade is fun as well. Boom, all of them just died. Brawler, the zombie officer, dead. Here go, let's loot the stuff. So I've already gotten here 3 green. And I don't think I'll be exchanging green for blue, as it's really, really not worth it. I'd rather keep opening up those green. And again, it's also not worth it. It's definitely not worth it to exchange your blue for purple. But whatever, I'll do it for the memes. But I don't want to waste my green cards. Because if you're going to get like 50 green, that means you're going to get at least like 100 weapons, right? You might get like 100 melee weapons. You might get like maybe 50 guns or something, you know? 50 guns, 50 melee weapons. That's what I'm trying to say. So you know what? Greens are really great. They're going to take you quite a bit of time to open them up. But doing like 99 waves is kind of expensive. It takes quite a bit of time to replenish your weapons. So you know what? I'm fine with opening up like hundreds and hundreds of green crates. I just say that every time in the police station because I do know that a lot of people underappreciate green cards. And at the same time, brown cards. If you just started playing the game, if you're new to the game, make sure to open up your brown cards as they aren't that bad. If you don't have anything else to open up, that is, because let's say if you have like 50 brown, then obviously exchange them for green. And if you have like a couple of green, then hey, open up green cards and don't bother about those brown cards. But if you have like 7 brown, then open up those brown cards. If you have like 10 brown, then don't exchange them for 1 green. Better open up your brown crates as they're not that bad. You'll get some healing items. You'll get some other stuff. Here we go. Boom, just exploded. Look at that grenade. Look at how many weapons we are saving. How many shots, like how much durability. Like this is insane. This is seriously, those grenades should be illegal. Sag, don't give developers any ideas. Don't worry, I don't think developers are gonna remove those grenades from police department because I don't think a lot of people will keep doing that as, yeah, it's gonna be even worse. So I don't think they're gonna do that, but I wouldn't be surprised. Oh no, throw the nade, throw the nade. Well, at least those guys spawned a little bit late, so that's good. I kind of failed. And they kind of failed to spawn in properly, so it's all good. And yeah, as I said, on wave 20, we are gonna use that mine. I think I've used around like 10 mines on the live stream. The more mines, the better. Wish there was a way to like grind those mines because you can only craft them. And wait, I want to see how expensive it is to craft the mines. Okay, so to craft a landmine, you require 4 steel plates and 3 of those explosive materials. So, you know what? Maybe they're not that bad. Like, I don't... if I wouldn't have to craft like 4 steel plates, you know? If I had, let's say 4 iron instead of that, then maybe I'd craft those mines. They're not that bad, but like 4 steel plates is kind of a lot. Like, seriously, I don't see anyone crafting them. Here we go. All of them are dead. Let's take the rest of the cards. Here we go. Another wave. Wave 18. Throw the nade, schmuck. I sometimes click F, but it just doesn't work. And yeah, for me, I throw my grenades on F because I... And no! I knew it! And now let's restart this terminal, boom, and probably with this snap of a finger, let's get back to my wave 18 or something. Okay, so here we go, we are back on this wave 18, let's start it, and after that we're gonna pick up all of the cards, so whatever, let's not mind a little bit of that lag here. I wanna go and open up all of those crates, I wanna see how many cards we'll get here, maybe I'll get some blue or whatever. I do know that if you're gonna place like that electronic circuit, you usually get less cards. That's like some sort of a conspiracy theory, but I was kinda able to confirm it a little bit. At least again, from my own personal experience, you do get less cards if you use your electronic circuit at least once. But again, maybe you do, maybe you don't. I have no idea. Doesn't really matter. We're gonna see right now. Hopefully this time I'm not gonna die. And I'm super surprised how on earth was I able to do 99 waves without dying. Like, that's just crazy. Like, there is literally 99 chances for me to die. And, I didn't die that time. I have no idea how that's even possible. Whatever, let's throw the nade. I think we'll do like 2 extra waves because I'm not really sure how many waves we've done now. If I've done 20 waves or 21, I'm not sure how it's gonna count. I think we've done 20 waves, not 21. 9 plus 10, 21. Okay, so let's get here and let's activate that 21 wave. I'm gonna... Oh no, I meant to use the nade. Whatever, the mine. We're gonna use the mine the next time. I mean, after this wave, we'll use another mine. Oh no, I escaped a bit early. One of those hungry chompers didn't get any damage. So let's get this mine right now. And I want to show for you how it works. So I'm going to get over here. We're going to place that mine. And here go. My guy's going to set it up. I'm going to leave it now. And we're going to start the wave. And all of these guys are just going to die. So probably this is the best usage of your mine. Boom. That's it. All of them just exploded. All of them are dead. So you know what we're going to do? I'm going to drop all of the tickets that I already have here, not the tickets, but these badges in this locker. So let's see how many badges I'm gonna get here right now, just like that. All right, so I collected all the cards and look at this. Here I've gotten 33 brown and 2 green, and here I've gotten 41 brown and 8 green. So like, once again, I'm just saying that there is something about it. If you're gonna use your electronic circuit, you will get less card. Maybe later on, you know, like on wave 80 or maybe on wave 90, you'll get more stuff. But we've just gotten like literally 4 times the amount of green cards during the first run, and I haven't even done 20 waves. Here I've done like what, 22 waves here. Like, imagine this, I've done like 22 waves. There I've done only like 17 or something, and I've even gotten more stuff. So yeah, don't use your electronic circuits. Again, this is like some sort of a proof. I still think like maybe this is like some sort of a conspiracy theory. Maybe I am overthinking this, but it happened like so many times, like so many times that you're getting less cards. And the point is, doing police department is really expensive. So why would you risk? Why would you take any risks, right? Okay, so let's talk to the raider and we're gonna exchange everything for green. Bada beam. I would love to go and open up more crates, but we've already opened up those blue cards during the live stream, so can't do that. And you know what? Let's go for the raid now. So welcome guys to the blind raid number 2, and it looks like we spawned in front of the chopper. Once again, I haven't done any research on this base, and the chopper doesn't have anything. Oh no, it actually does have a little bit of gasoline, but I didn't bring any empty bottles with me. I think it's always worth it to maybe bring like empty bottles in your chopper. Maybe, I don't know. Well, it looks like a really, really big base. Should I do research on it? Whatever, let's do research. Okay, so I've done a little bit of research, and this is going to be a really, really, really insane base. Oh no, why does he have so many horse feeders? I mean, obviously, I'm just gonna destroy those stupid horse feeders. They ain't no match for us. Here go, let's destroy this. Let's place that C4 here. So, okay, for those who don't know, in the past, you could probably craft like an unlimited amount of horse feeders, and you'd be able to get an unraidable base. So raiders technically can't go through those horse feeders. At least in the past, they couldn't go there, as there were no hatchets or something. I'm not really sure if AI raiders were still able to go through them. I don't know, but some people have crafted a bunch of horse feeders around their base. In any case, those horse feeders doesn't matter right now. Let's activate the sprinting skill because I can't wait to get inside of that base. So all I know is that we're gonna get a bunch of guns. But yeah, here, look at this, already just inside of the first chest, we're gonna get a little bit of guns. I do know that both of these chests are gonna get good stuff as well. And you can get like over 10 steel from this base. I'm just not sure where is it. I'm just not sure where that steel is. Whatever, I'll open up now another chest, and inside of this other chest, look at how many Glocks we're gonna get. It's just beautiful. Okay, so I actually know where we have to go, I think I know. Whatever, I'll try to chop down one of those walls, and we have to go through that wall, and there we're gonna get lots of steel as well. Yes, indeed. So inside of this chest, guys, we're gonna get lots and lots of steel. Just check this out. This is seriously one of the best bases I've raided, like top 20 bases. Look at this, bunch of steel. Maybe even like top one base with the amount of steel I've gotten here. Because I usually never gotten any bases where you can get lots and lots of steel. I do know that some people were really lucky to get like their full inventory of steel. Like, those kind of raids existed in the past, that's why developers have nerfed them. So yeah, in the past, you could literally, like, come back to the base with, like, 300 steel, you know? Like, you could have, like, seriously stolen 300 steel. And I do know that some people were lucky enough to get these kind of raids. I've never been able to get that much steel. So yeah, probably this is one of the first raids where I've gotten so much steel, like 10, 16 steel, basically. Because 6 copper can be transformed into 6 steel. Okay, so we'll keep opening up those chests. I just gotta get back to my chopper to drop those items. I do know that we could die to spawn back here, and maybe we'll do this. Maybe we will do that. I don't know. We'll see. But regardless, I'm really happy that I've done some research on this base because there's no way I'd be able to go from the top. I usually never go from the top. I would just go somewhere from over here. Yes, we've looted the pickup truck. That's what I wanted to see. So yeah, probably there's no way I'd be able to get to those chests. There's no way I'd have enough. Okay, I thought that the big one is chasing me because the screen was kind of lagging. It was kind of like shaking or something, and I thought the big one's coming. I was like, already? But whatever, let's open this up. Nothing over here. So probably in both of these chests, we're gonna get even more stuff. And that's all I know. I don't really know if we can get anything else in any of these chests, but I'll probably open them up. Okay, so let's get this. So inside of this chest, we're gonna get an M16, and here we are gonna get even more guns. Let's take them, baby. Let's take them. Okay, so maybe those chests have something else, but I've done even more research on this base. So we can chop down this wall. Please tell me I'll have enough time to do it before the big one spawns, because I didn't even bring a bit better armor. So I brought only like this broken armor. Maybe the big one can't even go through that stuff, so I'll have more time, but that doesn't matter. Just look at this. We're gonna open up this chest, and seriously, this is such an insane raid. I should have died right now, because probably if I'm gonna spawn back at this base, the big one's gonna spawn. So doesn't matter, just look at this. We're literally gonna take everything that I can. Such an awesome raid. Like, I can't believe it. So I'll take all of the first 8 guns that I can take. This is seriously, we're gonna get back home with full inventory of guns and healing items. That's insane. That never happens. That almost never happens. I'm gonna get rid of all the hatches. There's nothing else I need to take. I'm just gonna take these stuff. Boom, awesome. Okay, so I have some space over here. So I'm gonna take another stack of bandages. And what can I get rid of? I wanna get rid of this Glock for a stack of bandages, but you know what, I'll probably bring the Glock with me. And that's it, I have everything. My chopper is full, my inventory is full of stuff. I'm not even gonna summon the big one. You know what, I'm not stupid. I will actually summon the big one. Because why not? I wanna just chop this chest down, and that's it, just to see what we'll get inside, and then oh my god, this is such a cool raid. Well, at least I've eaten a little bit. Here, go, let's get this. Now, probably the big one's gonna spawn just on top of me, maybe. Maybe yes, maybe no. I'm activating the sprinting skill, and that's it. I'm skedaddling from this base. Wait, did the big one even spawn? Probably he did not. Doesn't matter. This base gets IX approval. So this base just went from top 20 to like probably top 5, top 10 bases that I've ever rated. Wow, such an awesome raid. I didn't even know these bases still exist. Basically 16 steel, bunch of first aid kits, bunch of bandages, and bunch of guns. Such an awesome raid. And great news, don't stop over there. Just as I said, let's talk about some sneak peeks that developers have shared with us. So boom, this is a new sneak peek that developers have shared with us. And I'm gonna tell you what I think this is, but before we do that, let's actually read what developers had to say about it. How's it going, folks? Hope all of you are doing just great. The work on the next update is underway and it will be released in about 2 weeks. This means you can spend the holiday not only with your friends and your darling ones, but also with your beloved game. This is epic. So 2 weeks from now is about on December 21st, so something like that. So probably we're gonna get it around December 18th to December 21st, like something like that again, if I had to guess, maybe even later. We know how much you're waiting for this update and your activity is extremely valuable to us. Thank you for all the comments and words of support we receive from you. It's very inspiring. Have a wonderful week, everyone. So new update is coming in about 2 weeks from now. That's great news. And now if I had to guess what this thing is going to be, so probably we will be loading packages on a boat from here, because developers have shared this different picture and here we can see the same crane loading packages on the boat. We can even zoom in a bit here and it's exactly the same crane that we see. So if I had to guess, we will be loading packages on a boat. So this is going to be somewhat of a continuation of season 12, because developers said that season 12 is going to be permanent content and we had those packages, like that delivery season. And that delivery season disappeared, but developers said that it's gonna come back. So probably season 13 is gonna have delivery through those cranes. So probably we'll be loading up our boats and we will send stuff. That's at least gonna be one part of it. At least that's what I think, because I don't know what else would that be. And also speaking about more sneak peeks, during season 11, developers shared like this sneak peek. They said that new base is coming to the game, but it's gonna be something different. It's gonna be more calm and we still have seen any of that. So what if season 13 is gonna have lots of cool stuff? What if we are gonna be able to build a base during season 13? What if this entire new location that we'll unlock will give us a new base over there? It's gonna be more calm. I don't know, everything's possible. Everything is possible. But whatever that is going to be, the most important is that season 13 is going to be permanent content. So I can't wait until we'll get it. So it looks like this December is going to be really awesome, because we're gonna get this Last on Earth update. Cyberpunk 2077 is coming out and we're gonna be playing it here on the channel. And December is always cool. It has awesome vibes because it's Christmas. So I highly suggest you checking out my The Witcher 3 video, or click here on the second card and you'll go to my Minecraft Let's Play, or hop over to my channel, go to playlist, and there you'll find a lot of other games that I played here on the channel. If you're not subscribed yet, definitely be sure to jump the subscribe button and notification bell to not miss any future videos. And consider following me on Instagram or Twitter at Epicyric. Mm-hmm. Yep.